They hear what you think. Yes, it is true. It is happening all around you. If you are someone who is manifesting a specific person, then this will be a game changer for you. As Neville Goddard said in his lecture, others only echo that which we whisper to them in secret. The whisper here simply means the thoughts you indulge in your imagination. Whatever you are imagining about another is what you are whispering to them, and they hear whatever you imagine about them. You can try it out. Just leave your specific person and think about a friend for a moment or even a family member. Just think about them and give them compliments in your mind. Talk to them as if they are the best thing that has happened to you. Just involve yourself in beautiful conversations with them in your imagination. Now, the next time you meet them, you will see a wonderful side of them. They heard what you whispered to them in secret, and now they are reflecting it in your physical reality. Imagine their smiling faces and the love in their eyes. Imagine that they like you as you are, and that you are enough. Now do the same thing that you did in your imagination with your specific person. I have seen people cursing their specific person, holding this negative story in their minds, remembering the times when their specific person had no contact with them or blocked them. This happens, it is human nature, but only if you go beyond this nature will you be able to manifest different outcomes, as your specific person is just a projection of your mind. According to Neville Goddard, imagination is God, and everything that exists in your imagination exists, and your physical reality is just a projection of your imagination. You can hear it in many different terms, like the internal world is projecting your external reality. The physical world is just a reflection of your inner world. Whatever you imagine manifests in external reality. Now the fun part is that your specific person is also a part of that imagination, and therefore they are a projection of your mind. They are a projection of your internal reality. Now whatever you assume about them or whatever you believe about them gets projected into your external reality. Daily, you all indulge in some tiny inner conversations. You have these conversations with yourself. They are about someone or something. During these moments, you are forming assumptions. The majority of the time, these conversations are unconscious. You are unaware due to your everyday thinking pattern. You indulge in them every day, and later they are reflected back to you in your external reality as evidence. Within your inner world and within your consciousness, the whole world exists. When you imagine, only you can see and only you can hear. There is no one else but you. Even if you imagine a specific person, then it is also you. You play their part, and you play your own part within your imagination. That is why you hear Neville Goddard say, "There is no one to change but yourself." It is because only you are aware of what you are thinking. Only you are aware of your imaginal acts, and therefore only you exist in your imagination. Whenever you are having an inner conversation, you are playing the part of yourself and your specific person. Now suppose there is a girl named Neela who is manifesting her partner named Adrian. Now, whenever she closes her eyes, she imagines herself with a specific person. Till now, she only knew that imagination creates reality, and that there is no one to change but herself. She was unaware that, in her imagination, everything she sees, touches, and hears is also herself. That is why she is part of everything that is in her imagination. When she hears Adrian tell her that she is a princess, and that she is lovely, then, Neela is playing two parts. The first part is Neela, the receiver of the compliments, and also as Adrian, the giver of the compliment. Now, it is not limited to the giver and receiver. The compliment is also Neela. Now it all will sound illogical, but it is what it is. Consciousness contains everything. Also, Neela, as a name for a person or as an identity, is not consciousness. But Neela is a character that God is playing in this physical world. Her imagination and her awareness are what define the roles she wants in her physical experiences. For now, just understand that whenever you are imagining a specific person, you are playing their part as well. You are also them. Therefore, do the lovely things. Imagine the lovely things. Imagine them loving you and telling you lovely things. Now, I know you never thought of it this way. Maybe this was a little tiny block that you had previously. Till now, you never thought the true meaning behind everyone as you pushed out. You never thought that person could be you. Now you know that when you imagine them, you are imagining yourself. Now, it won't be difficult for you to imagine a lovely, favorable outcome where you are with your specific person. Now, it won't be difficult to play the mind movie where you are celebrating your anniversary with a specific person. You never change anything on the outside. You always change everything on the inside. By changing the inside, it simply means choosing what you want to experience or what you want to happen. Choosing the reality you wish to experience. Now, Neville did it too. He manifested his specific person. In his lecture He Is Dreaming Now, which was published in 1970, he mentions a part of his story. He said that he met his wife in 1936, and it was love at first sight. At that time, she was not with him, and she didn't even know that she would be his wife. She was definitely not in love with him at that time, but Neville knew that she was going to be his wife. In another lecture, he mentioned that he liked this woman and wanted to marry her. He went to bed and slept as though he was happily married to the love of his life. He continued this scene for 1 week, and it manifested later. He had an old wife who was not giving him a divorce, but she got involved in a shoplifting case and gave Neville the divorce. He got what he imagined. Although the reality was opposite, he still married the partner he wanted just by imagining himself sleeping next to her in his imagination. His imagined act became a reality, and it can happen for you too. Neville went to the end and started living there. He didn't concern him with the steps. He didn't concern him with what had to be done. He had this desire to marry the woman. He started imagining a life with her, and it happened. So, go to the end and choose the version of yourself and your specific person that you want to experience. The current reality might be totally opposite, but imagine the end, because the end is where it all will begin. Ask yourself, if you were with your SP, how would you feel? Imagine that feeling, feel it, and stay there. Ask yourself such questions. If I were with my SP, how would I think about myself and how would I think about them? How would you live your life? Would you still be locking yourself in your bedroom and feeling sad? Would you still stalk their social media profile? Would you still seek any signs? Would you still compare yourself with third parties? Would you still think that you are not good enough for them? Would you still think that they don't want you? You won't, right? But just look at the thoughts you entertain throughout the day. If you are stalking your SP's social media, if you are seeking any signs, if you are comparing yourself with some third party, if you are thinking that you are not good enough and that you are not wanted, then you are just living in a place where your specific person is not with you. All these thoughts and assumptions are natural and very common. But if you want to do something uncommon, you have to ask yourself this question. If I am with my SP, what would be my assumptions? And that is your answer. Those are your affirmations. This is how you will live in the end. Circumstances do not matter. You have the power to change yourself. You have the power to change your reality. And you have the power to change your circumstances. It is what you choose that matters. All you can possibly need or desire is already yours. Call your desires into being by imagining and feeling your wishes fulfilled. Everything exists. Every version of yourself and your specific person exists. It is just like that you haven't called that version yet in your reality. You haven't imagined and persisted in that version of yourself and them. If you think that your current circumstances are final and permanent, and that they cannot be changed, then you are lying to yourself. If that were the case, then no one would ever rise from failure, no one could ever be healed, and no one could ever make a transformation. But there are people who did it. There are people who changed. Even you changed. You are now totally different from your previous states, where you had your specific person. Become aware of what you are thinking, and you will recognize a relationship between your mood and your surrounding circumstances. Your circumstances will show you exactly where you are living internally. Also, as I explained at the beginning of the video, your specific person is actually you. They are a part of you. They are you pushed out. So, just ask yourself what you want and then give it to yourself. Do not question how it will come about. Just go your way, knowing that the evidence of what you have done must appear, and it will. Your imagination is very powerful, and it is a creative tool that makes things possible. You are the giver as well as the receiver. Give it in your imagination and receive it there. Then, physically, you will receive it, and you will know what you have done. If you are someone who struggles to get into the state of having their wish fulfilled, then I have created a general affirmation tape that will take you to a state where you get what you desire. Just listen to it for 21 days, and you will see a change within you. You can find it by clicking on the first video that appears at the end of the screen.